Do y'all think I look like a boy? Don't answer that! Please don't answer that!
The world is simply an obstacle course for wheelchair users. Here's an example. Train tracks. My casters get swallowed into these giant cracks every time. So, to avoid feeding those hungry cracks and ending up face first on the concrete, I wheelie over each and every one. A tiny wheelie, but a wheelie nonetheless. When there's this many in a row, it's best to keep them small. After all, you really don't need that much air. And the world is full of little inaccessibilities like these, so that's why.
Crack a rib when I get
home. Nothing makes me scared. Do you see my hands? Do they look like they shaking to you? No.
10 minutes, swear to God. You can play with this kaleidoscope I got you at the airport.
What? A kaleidoscope? I'm not five.
Shapes and colors the likes of which I've never seen.
Sensory issues is a nightmare, but I can think of one instance where I guess it turned out to be a good thing. I don't really know. I grew up in the time where it was very popular to pluck your eyebrows to the point that they were like a thin pencil line, and my mother trying to help me socially fit in was like, hey, let's pluck your eyebrows. And I was like, sure. I didn't really know what that entailed. And that was horrific. I hated plucking my eyebrows. It was torture. And I was like, nope, we are not doing this. So after a few times, we never plucked my eyebrows again. I was like, absolutely not. I grew up with people saying that I had bushy eyebrows. And I was like, yes, they remind me of caterpillars. And I freaking love caterpillars. But time passed and trends change as they do. And all of a sudden, people were like, wow, it's such a blessing you didn't pluck your eyebrows because now you have bushy eyebrows. And I'm like, thanks. Sensory issues. I don't know. I guess I'll take the win that I didn't pluck my eyebrows due to sensory issues. Now people are like, you have great eyebrows. I'm like, thanks. I don't know. I don't really care. It's just hair on my face. I just don't enjoy plucking. It's torture.
Why don't you get it? Can't you get it? Understand. They're gonna execute the mother. To elevate the man, we're gonna propagate the killer, eliminate the youth. We're gonna blind date everyone until you love them too. We're gonna blind date everyone until you love them too.
If you're delivering packages to a property that has a ramp outside, chances are they're going to be using a wheelchair or mobility aid to get into their house.
If you leave boxes on the ramp like this, it causes an obstruction. I can't reach my front door key to get in, and there's no way I can move these boxes because they're so heavy.
And I'm completely off balance.
Ugh. And if I'm already in the property, don't just dump it and run, because now I can't get out of my property and then it becomes a safety issue. Be a champ, leave it off the ramp.
My cock. Where's my cock?
What?
My cock.
Hey, want to try this new food?
Oh, I'm okay, thank you. I'm actually, like, really picky. Like, I'm, like, a really picky eater. Like, I'm really picky.
What kind of music are you into?
I kind of only listen to a couple bands right now, because, like, when I get into an artist, I get, like, really into them. Like, really into them. So, yeah. Do you mind if I leave a bit early?
Oh, okay.
It's kind of just, like, really loud here, like really loud, and there's a lot of people, so like, yeah, do you mind if I just head back to somewhere quiet?
Hey, what's your sexuality?
I don't really know. I kind of have a really complicated relationship with my sexuality and my gender, now that you mention it.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck I am, actually.
Could you grab something for me? It's actually just, like, upstairs in the room to the left, in the drawer of the cabinet next to the bed, in the top drawer.
I'm sorry,
drawer.
I'm not gonna remember any of that.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. I'm just really bad at, like, taking multiple instructions at once. Like, do you mind showing me where that is?
That would defeat the purpose of you getting the thing.
Oh. Sorry. Rest in peace to all the soldiers that die in the service. I
die in her cervix. How are you doing that?
I don't know, Lois. I'm scared. So let me be, and I'll set you free. Oh,
yeah. I am in misery. Maybe I'm an outfit repeater, but you're an outfit rememberer, which is just as pathetic.
You guys probably fought girls in juvie.
No, we were lying about that, obviously.
About juvie?
Yeah, I mean,
why would you lie to me?
Did you know that today's the last college class that I'll ever go to with Yiddies? Do you know that this is the last time I'll ever see you with Yiddies? Do you know this is the last time I'll ever go to the gym with Yiddies? Do you know this is the last time that I'll ever go out to dinner with Yiddies? Do you know that this is the last full month that I'll ever have Yiddies?
Has anyone else transitioned without telling their parents? I have not seen my parents in over a year, and in the past year, I've gotten top surgery, I've been on testosterone for several months now, my voice has lowered considerably, and my parents still have no idea. They don't even know I'm transgender. And next month, I'm going to be seeing my parents for the first time in over a year, and I'm not really sure what to tell them, and part of me doesn't really want to come out to them. I honestly kind of want to gaslight them. I just tell them, like, hey, what do you mean? My voice has always been this way. I've never had boobs. Don't you remember the first 18 years of my life you raised a boy? I literally want to gaslight them rather than come out to them. I kind of just want to pretend this is the way I've always been, you know?